This episode of DNews is brought to you by Jack Threads. Do you want to know what color gets me in the mood? Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. The colors, man, the colors! If you're not completely colorblind, kid, you might associate certain colors with certain feelings. But the idea that colors affect mood seems like, well, like baloney to me. But studies as far back as the 1930s show that people, at least in the Western world, associate colors with specific feelings. We use colors as metaphors for emotions. Red represents anger, while blue is seen as serene and dignified. A study published more recently in BMC Medical Research Methodology found this to hold true. Some healthy people picked a happy yellow as associated with their mood, while some people with depression and anxiety picked shades of gray to describe their mood. Colors can even change the way drugs work. Seriously, the color blue makes for better sedatives, while red makes stimulants more effective. Speaking of red, there really seems to be some strong feels surrounding the hot hue. Red seems to be a universal color that means stop, danger, or hot. While you might think this has to do with culture, it might have to do with our biology. One study in the journal Emotion found that when people see red, they react stronger and faster. Red is often seen as the sexy color, and one study published in the Journal of Experimental Social Psychology found that to hold up across different cultures. But it's not just people. One study published in the journal Psychological Science found that male rhesus macaques avoid or act submissively around someone who wears red. Another study published in the journal Evolution and Human Behavior found that female macaques tend to gaze longer at images of male hindquarters surrounded by frames of red than the same image framed with blue. So maybe the roots of red reactions lie deep within our DNA. Some scientists think this could be because red is so important for communication. A flushed face could signal that someone is angry or maybe ready to hit the sheets. But other colors carry meaning too. Kermit would be happy to know that it's pretty easy while calming being around green. One study published in the journal Environmental Science and Technology found that the color green might make you enjoy your workout more. The researchers found that men who looked at the color green while working out were less tired and had less mood disturbances. Other studies show that colors with shorter wavelengths like blue and green evoke feelings of calmness. A study published in Applied Psychology, Health and Well-being found that kids with ADHD experience fewer symptoms after playing in an outdoor green space. Green might also enhance your creativity, according to a study published in the journal Personality and Social Psychology Bulletin. These benefits of green might be because a lush green landscape meant a fertile land with plenty of food for our ancestors. Blue can mean a few different things too. One shade might be calming, while a darker hue might signal sadness. But blue light might perk us up. One reason might be because blue acts on our biological clock. On a bright sunny day, the sky is a brilliant blue, telling us to be awake. This is one of the reasons why the blue light from your laptop and phone screens can keep you awake at night. So if you want to get pumped up, you should be seeing red. Want to calm down? Surround yourself with hues of blue and green. And if you want to put yourself and others in a good mood, try changing the color of your shirt. For all you guys out there, check out Jack Threads. Jack Threads is the only place you need to shop to find the best gear that won't break the bank. They have stylists on call to make shopping a no-brainer, plus tons of great brands to select from. On top of the already great prices, get an additional 15% off by visiting jackthreads.com/dnews and entering coupon code DNews at checkout. Speaking of color, have you ever wondered if we all see the same color? Like, is your red the same as my red, or is your red like my blue? Check out this video here. Anthony throws on his rose-colored glasses and takes a look.
Here's the thing. The number of cones in people's eyes vary hugely. And the kinds of cones aren't evenly distributed, so one person may have mostly red cones, while someone else has more blue.
All right, guys, how do colors affect you? Let us know down in the comments below, and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week.